brown potatoes. Just dump that right in your pot. Little Smokies cocktail sausages. We're just gonna dump that right in. Take one can of cream of chicken soup. Dump that right on top. And now we're gonna fill that with some milk. I'm using this 1% organic milk. Let me know in the comments if you think organic is worth the extra price or if it's just a waste of money. We're gonna use it for this one. Pour that milk in there. That's gonna combine with those potatoes and it's gonna be perfect. I'm gonna take some white onion. I used about a third, but you can use a whole onion if you like. I'm gonna put it in our handy dandy chopping machine. You really have to put your weight on it. Why is it so hard? Okay, I got it.
You got it?
Now we're gonna dump our chopped onion right into the pot. All right, now it's time for everybody's favorite. I need some cheese.
Cheese, that's in the fridge. Can do that. Cheese is right here. All right, triple cheddar.
Now, the recipe calls for about a cup and a half, but you could use as much as you want because y'all always tell me I'm too stingy with cheese. We're just gonna kind of dump it in. And you're gonna add a little bit more too after we stir, so you can ration that out. Now we need some seasoning. We're gonna do some onion powder and garlic powder. There we go. Salt and pepper.
Pepper it up, okay.
And ta-da!
Ooh,
isn't that nice?
Handy.
All right, and now we just stir that up. Remember, we've got the condensed cream of chicken soup, so you really wanna spread that out so that it really kind of covers all of the potatoes and all of the weenies. All right, there we go. We got that all mixed up. Lastly, we're gonna just top that with just one more sprinkling of cheese right on top. And that's it, y'all. We've got a yummy dinner casserole, or this could even be breakfast as well. We're gonna cook this on high for 3 hours, and then we're gonna taste test.
This is exciting.
All right, y'all, guess what? Our potato sausage casserole is ready for the taste test. I'm excited to try this one. We ended up cooking it in the crock pot for about 2.5 hours. So this one can go on high 2 to 3 hours. And this is one that you could even take the lid off and pop it in the oven if you want to brown the top a little bit too. But just to recap what we have in there, we've got lots of yummy things. And you know what's great? This one could even be for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. All these ingredients could be for any of those meals. But we have our hash brown potatoes, we have our Little Smokies cocktail sausages, we have a can of cream chicken soup, a little bit of milk, and then we've got some spices and cheese and a little bit of onion.
Wow. Hey, by the way, do you know where onions go to have a drink?
Kyle's got jokes. Where do onions go to have a drink?
A salad bar.
That's such a Kyle joke. All right, that was cute. We'll give you that one. Time for the taste test. Ooh, this looks good.
All right,
take a look at that, y'all.
Look at that.
So this is going to be delicious. I can already tell. I'm gonna go ahead and scoop a big piece out.
All right.
Now this is a creamy casserole. See? I think that's a big enough serving there.
All right.
So this is almost like an au gratin potatoes because they definitely have that kind of consistency with the cheese. We've got our sausages. Let me cut one in half. All right. You want the first bite or is it me?
Okay, here we go.
What's the verdict?
It's good. I could see this as a side.
Well, this could be a side dish or it could be your main meal because you've got a little bit of everything. You got your carbs and your protein, got some veggies in there. Either way, I think this is a winner. This is gonna definitely please the whole family. Into the crumbler. Perfect. Potatoes in the bottom. Add some baby carrots. And some chopped onion. Just enough to create a small layer on the bottom of your crock pot. Now it's time to add some spices. We'll start with some oregano. Paprika.
Okay.
Garlic powder.
Okay.
Try to get that lined up as best as you can. Crushed black pepper. Onion powder. And last, we're gonna have some salt. There we go. You always say I don't use enough seasoning, so let me know what you think of these. So we've got a beautiful 4-pound chicken here, and you don't wanna get one that's too big because then it won't fit in the crock pot, and this is a 4-quart crock pot. This is a perfect fit for it. You want it to lay right on top of those vegetables. Press it down. That's perfect. Now we're gonna add some olive oil. We're just gonna pour that right over the top of our chicken. Now, I know y'all probably think I'm crazy, but trust me, y'all, this is actually gonna work. It's gonna be delicious. You can cook a chicken in the crock pot. Why would you want to do that? Well, maybe because your oven's already so full with all the other delicious stuff that you're making, this frees up oven space. But you just want to really rub that around. Perfect. You're just going to take your spatula and mix that up.
Okay.
Get a nice mix. I had a lot of paprika in that one, but I really like the flavor of paprika. Our chicken, and just kind of rub it around. That's gonna be good, isn't it?
Yeah.
Are you gonna be impressed with me if this actually turns out?
Yeah.
And then now we need some rosemary.
Rosemary. Mm-hmm. Rosemary.
Fresh herbs are definitely the way to go with this one. So you can stick some rosemary right in there into the cavity, and that's gonna give it a nice flavoring.
It's like a forest.
It does look like a little forest. All right, we got our rosemary in there, all the beautiful seasonings. Y'all always tell me I don't use enough seasoning, so we definitely used more this time. Now, adjust your timing depending on how big your crock pot is, but for this size crock pot, 4 hours should do the trick.
We shall see.
So we got our chicken cooking, but Kyle wants to show us something with our extra carrots.
Yeah, so get the carrot chopper in position.
It's our veggie chopper.
All right, so put that right there. Right. I'm just gonna take one of these carrots and I'm gonna put it in that little bottom hole right there, like that. And now put the middle hole, put your finger in the middle hole. No, not another carrot, your finger.
You want?
Put your finger in the middle hole, yeah, all the way through. All the way through, like okay. This. Pull it in this way. And I'll see, I'll take this blade part right here. You can let go.
Okay.
And see that blade right there?
I'm watching.
That blade's gonna go right, see it going through that hole, right on top of your finger, like that. And now you're gonna just slap that top as hard as you can. Ready? One.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, just trust me. Ready? One, two, three, slap it. Look at cut the carrot. How did you do to pull the blade out? Pull the blade out.
Oh my God. By the way, we're magicians, just in case you didn't know that.
Yeah, don't try this at home.
Don't try this at home.
Three, two.
All right, y'all. The chicken is done, I hope. Now, as I said, this is the first time I've ever made a whole chicken in the crock pot. The recipe actually said 4 to 5 hours. Initially, I thought it would be 4 hours, but I checked the temperature, and it recommends to get around 160, 165. So it took about 5 hours to get us there, and we're about to see if we can get this chicken out of the crock pot. Okay.
Okay, looks good.
You peeked, didn't you? Because there was no steam. He peeked. I bet he did when I didn't know. But it is freshly made, and now I got to figure out how to get this out of here. Okay. Now, remember, we've got the veggies underneath
the chicken. You said VGs.
We've got the veggies underneath.
Okay.
All right, how do I get this out? We're going to cut it open.
Maybe just grab the legs.
Okay, so you've got all these beautiful juices down there, too, by the way. And that will make a nice gravy if you... Oh, here we go.
All right, ready?
It looks good. Whoa, it's heavy. Okay, we got the chicken out, and it looks pretty good. And look at these veggies, they've all been cooked in this
veggies
nice
look good.
Juice. You can use that for gravy.
I think we really want to see how the
chicken. Okay, look at that. Oh, this looks good. Oh, my goodness. It actually looks really juicy.
Swinging it around. Okay, there you go. Cut a piece out. Let's see.
Okay, cut a piece.
Do a taste test here.
Okay, here we go. Oof, it's all falling. It's like nice and juicy. Everything.
You are just falling all apart. All right.
Get my good piece of chicken.
Okay.
All right.
Are you going to give it a shot? Mm-hmm.
I didn't overdo it with paprika. It's good.
Really? Try it. All right, here we go.
It's very juicy.
Mmm. Wow.
It's good, right?
You know, I thought this was going to be a nightmare, but it wasn't bad.
You can make chicken in your crock pot. Now, varying times for cooking, so just make sure the temperature's up there at 165 degrees, 160 degrees, and then you've got your dinner. You got 1 pound of beef strips, and these have been pre-marinated in some teriyaki sauce. Just spread that on the bottom. Now, I've got some frozen tri-color pepper and onions medley. This has been thawed and drained just a little bit. How colorful and beautiful is that? This just makes it easy and convenient. And did you know that frozen foods are just as good as fresh? It's true.
Didn't know that.
Now we're gonna add some light brown sugar. You're gonna take about 1/4 cup of that. Dump that into a bowl. And next, we're gonna add some beef broth. About 1.5 cups of beef broth. There we go. Pour that in. And would you do me a favor? And in the fridge, you'll find some soy sauce. Would you grab me that soy sauce?
Sure.
Get that. Low sodium, so it's healthier option.
Soy sauce.
Perfect, thank you. And would you hold that for me? Because now I'm gonna take my tablespoon and we're gonna put out about 1 tablespoon of soy sauce. I could have used 2, but since our beef was already marinated, we're just gonna use the 1. Then we're gonna add some light to that one. Just gonna stir that up just so that our brown sugar is mixed thoroughly. And we're gonna take that liquid and pour it right over the top. Just enough so that it's saturated. This is gonna be delicious. We're gonna add a little bit of fresh ground black pepper. And are y'all like me? Do you just eyeball it when it comes to ingredients, or do you like to use exact measurements? Sometimes y'all are in the comments saying, Mistie, tell me exactly how many teaspoons you use. I can't tell you that because I don't always know. I'm just using my heart with this. Now, we've got everything we need. We're gonna cover this and cook it on either low for 4 to 5 hours or on high for 2 to 3. And then you've got a delicious dinner that you can serve over rice. All right, y'all, our pepper steak is ready. It cooks quite fast. We're gonna give that a stir. Ooh, doesn't that smell good?
Yeah.
Wow, this actually smells really good. And also, this is beef, so sometimes people like their beef to be cooked medium. They like it to be a little bit pink. What do you think? How do you like your steak done? Look at that. Now I've got some rice. I've chosen the brown rice because we are making this the healthy way. And we're just gonna add our beef and veggies right over to the top. And the last thing that we need is some sesame seeds. That's just for garnish. Just sprinkle that over the top.
All right.
Ooh, that looks good, doesn't it? Okay, is that meat cooked perfectly for you?
It looks good to me.
Okay, so we've got our rice, we've got peppers and onions. This is actually a quite healthy dinner. Do you want the first bite?
Sure.
Don't burn your mouth.
They're hot.
I just said don't burn your mouth. What do we think? Do we like the taste of it?
It's so good.
Oh, the beef is perfect. I'm scared I'm going to burn my mouth. Oh, I like it.
It's good, isn't it?
This is a really good combination of flavor.
So nice over the rice like this.
Mm-hmm. Quick and easy dinner. Y'all, let me know what you think about this one. And tell me what else you'd add to it.